which is distributed in the volume. Okay, so you have a solid sphere. This is a non-metallic sphere, and charges are uniformly distributed in the volume. And let's say volume charge density is rho. Get it? Okay. So spherically distributed charge. Fine. I am trying to find out the potential of this entire charge at a distance r which is greater than capital R. Then what should be? The potential is, if point lies outside, the entire sphere will behave like a
point
charge located at the center. Why? Because you can consider a spherical object as if it is made up of spherical shells of different radius. Okay? So every shell will behave like a point charge. So everything behaves like a point charge if point is outside. This point is outside, where small r is greater than capital R, right? So potential will be what? At a distance small r, potential will be k q by r, right? Now can we expand this? Write value of k, value of q, and should we find out how much it is? Done? K is what? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. What is Q in terms of rho?
1 by
4 pi epsilon naught. Rho into 4 by 3 pi capital R cube. This will be small r. So this one is straightforward if point is outside. This will be rho R cube divided by 3 epsilon naught small r. Fine? This is the potential at a point r which is greater than capital R. Okay? Fine. Now let's try to find out potential at a point r which is less than capital R. I am trying to find potential over here.
So, won't it be the same thing but bigger becomes smaller?
Yeah.
Yeah.
In this case?
Yeah.
No. Don't use any thumb rule just like this randomly. Apply some concept and then tell me that I have used this basic concept and got this as answer. Okay? So I give you a hint. You draw an hypothetical sphere like this. Okay? I want to find out potential on the surface of this. So this much charge is inside and that much charge is outside. Okay? Had it been electric field, suppose I want to ask, let's say electric field, then what will happen? Only this much charge will create electric field. But if it is potential, then this much charge will act like a point charge. And what will happen due to these charges? Will potential be zero because of these charges? No. No. Okay? So you can write down potential as potential because of the inner plus potential due to the outer charge. Find out this and that separately and add them up. Tell me how much you get. Did you get V in? Potential due to the inner sphere. The inner one will act as if it is a point charge located at the center.
Q by what?
What is Q?
Oh,
yeah. This is smaller. Got it? What is V in? V in will be K into charge of this divided by small r. Yes or no? This entire sphere will behave like a point charge located at the center. Right? So K is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Q is 4 by 3. Pi r cube, this into rho divided by r. Any doubt?
No, sir. I know.
4 pi cancel it and get this square. This will be equal to rho r square divided by 3 epsilon naught. Okay? This is the potential because of the inner sphere. Okay? Now try to find out potential due to the outer sphere. Why do you say that? What is the reason for it? Tell me.
Because the charge of the area has to be charged the entire
system. No, sir. Entire.
You got the total charge, suppose. You have the total charge. Then? K, Q into? Divided by?
R minus
R. R minus R is this distance. Why? What is the reason for that?
So,
let me first. Yeah. No reason? See, the thing is that this entire charge is outside the point. Okay? So, if there is a point inside the sphere, inside a hollow sphere, the potential will be constant anywhere inside, as if the potential is on the surface. Now, there is not just one hollow sphere, there are like many hollow spheres. Starting from r equal to small r till r equal to capital R, there are multiple hollow spheres you can imagine over here. Okay? And potential of every hollow sphere is different, yes or no? So you need to add them up. All the hollow spheres starting from this point to that point, potential due to them, you have to add up to get the total potential due to all the hollow spheres. Are you getting the point? Who did not get it? Please feel free. Everybody understood? Okay. Now let's assume a hollow sphere of radius x. This is a hollow sphere of radius x, and the width of the hollow sphere is dx. Let us say. The width is dx and the radius is x. Fine. Now tell me, what will be the potential due to just this hollow sphere? How much it will be?
KQ by x.
And which Q? Q of the shell. Q of the shell. Okay? So basically, this is dV out. Potential due to the outer surface for this spherical shell will be equal to K, charge on the shell, let's say dQ is the charge, divided by X. Okay? And how much is the charge on the shell? Can you tell me that? Rho into 4 pi X square dx. The volume of this shell is surface area into dx. Okay? So dV out is K, which is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, rho 4 pi x square dx divided by x. Any doubt? Doubt? This is the potential due to a shell at a distance x. Okay? And x can change from where to where? Small r to capital R. So when you integrate, the limit of x will be small r to capital R. Now do it quickly. Okay, so this will be equal to rho r square by 2 epsilon naught minus rho small r square by 6 epsilon naught. So if I take rho by 6 epsilon naught common, I get 3 capital R square minus small r square. This is the potential inside the volume charge distribution in a sphere.
So, can you not do it another way? Where you take as Qt by R square and Q will be equal to rho into the volume of that.
You're finding total volume of this.
Yeah.
But the potential, which distance you will take from this point, which distance you will take? You want to find potential over here because of all these charges. So K into this charge divided by what? Divided by what? You don't know, right? Because the potential of this point and that point are different.
Yeah.
You can't just add up total charge. But the best part about the inner charge is that the inner charge will behave as if it is a point charge. So there you can just directly write. But the outer one, potential at every point, potential due to every point will be different at that point. That's why you have to integrate for outer. Okay? Did you find this difficult? This one? This usually people skip. So basically, if you place a point charge Q inside the sphere at a distance small r, the potential energy will be small Q into this potential. Okay? I think similar thing we did for gravitation also. Potential. Gravitation. That is called gravitational potential. Okay, now let's take up questions. I am taking slightly, in model question. This is the axis, okay? This is the axis of the disk. This disk has surface charge density sigma. Okay? Radius is capital R. This disk is fixed. There is a mass small m and charge small q which is placed at a height h. Understood? Now when you release it, what will happen? Gravity is acting down, but there is electrostatic force acting which direction? If you assume that both sigma into q is greater than zero, they are of same sign, repulsion will happen, it will go up, right? Alright, now here is the thing. It starts from here, point number one. Okay? Fine, there is a repulsion between this and that. And it stops momentarily at a height small h. Getting your point? Okay? It drops from here, this mass is dropped from here along the axis and it stops here. Fine? You need to find out what is the value of sigma in terms of everything else. The hint is conservation of energy, that work energy theorem, nothing else. Very simple form, very simple numerical if you think simple. That is why I said momentarily at rest. Just substitute the value, write down W is equal to this. You don't need to solve it. Just write it like an equation and leave it. It becomes very complicated because I have not given values, right?
Sigma is the charge or the charge distribution?
Charge density. Surface charge density. Charge per unit area.
Both the positions of the kinetic energy will be zero.
Let's not discuss how to solve right now. First, attend to yourself. Okay. Should I do it now? What is K1? 0 K2 0, W 0. Three things are 0. U1 gravitational potential energy, MGH, electrostatic potential energy, Q into potential energy at point 1, sorry, potential at point 1. U2 is what? Mg into small h plus Q into V2. Okay? What is V1? V1 is equal to sigma kata formula, sigma by 2 epsilon naught. Then under root of r square plus h square minus, what else? Minus h. This is V1, right? V2 is sigma by 2 epsilon naught under root r square plus small h square minus small h. Just substitute here and you get the value of sigma. Okay? This came in JEE Advanced, couple of years back. Understood, entire? If you break down the entire problem into its small, small parts, you see how simple it flows. You know, all the concepts are so well connected. And another thing which is very important is clarity in thoughts, in physics at least, you know. Because in physics, if you start thinking randomly, there is no limit. You start thinking about black holes while writing JEE exam. Okay? There is no limit up to which you can think nonsense, right? So clarity of thought is more important than solving a lot of problems. Except the fact that physics is very simple, if you keep it simple.